Erev Tov Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Russia's not playing around, getting ready. We were really beginning to suspect that Russia would not be willing to defend Syria in the event of a U.S.-led coalition invasion inside the country. But the latest word coming out is that Russia has joined forces with Iran, saying that they would take on the United States if they do this again, if they try to do any kind of attack whatsoever. Surprising as that may be, we're seeing even the evidence of that already on the ground. Another shocker that we're going to share with you in our broadcast tonight is that President Xi of China and the United States, along with Japan, look like they have joined forces together to take down North Korea's Kim Jong-un. And that may be by force, with 150,000 troops moved up onto the northern border of North Korea. United States and South Korea there getting ready to do an attack there, and Japan and the United States working together to do an invasion on the coastlines of North Korea there. These are events that are about to transpire, and what's going to shock you even more, every bit of this is biblical, every bit of this has been prophesied, and it looks like Donald Trump is the very man that's going to carry that all out. I'm Stephen Benoon. Let's get right into the message here today on Israeli News Live about these types of events that we're speaking about here now. Topwar.ru, the Russian language news online news source here, speaking about that the Russians have moved in some very special new anti-missile weapon system there after the failure of the S-300 and the S-400 systems, or the C-400 troop system there. And as a result, they have moved in the Buk-M3. The Buk-M3 is a brand new missile defense system that Russia has developed there. Much smaller, much more lighter, very agile and easy to move around, and very, of course, very mobile, you might say there. That system there, according to Sputnik News, that was developed and came out last year in 2016, says it's called the Aircraft Killer, new Russian Buk-M3 SAM system to enter service soon. Well, it is now inside of Syria, which lets us know that Russia is taking very serious any other provocations by President Trump on the Syrian government there. Looks like he is going to stand by his man there, President Bashar al-Assad. And again, I really kind of hold to the fact that I do not believe that President Bashar al-Assad is guilty of any chemical weapons upon his own people, although it is appearing more and more that what happened was the weapons storage facility that they were targeting there inside of Syria, that the Syrian government did hit, contained chemical weapons that were being stored by the Syrian rebels. We got some new information about that. Going to share that with you here in just a moment there. And again, as we've stated all along there, Bashar al-Assad has certainly been targeted by the entire world. Even that we see as well of we find that with President Erdogan. As I did a news broadcast on Erdogan back in September, and on this news broadcast right here, we titled it, Erdogan Betrays Putin with Staged Coup to Invade Syria. I did this video here on September the 7th of 2016. We've stated it many other times since that time that Erdogan has been playing Russia all along, and that President Putin shouldn't even trust him so far as he could throw the man. And we have seen that this is really carrying out. As I stated before, he's using the opportunity to get troops, get tanks, all the military equipment into northern part of Syria, so that when NATO was ready to do the invasion on Syria, that the Turkish military would already be in place, as he fakes the coup to get in the good graces of President Putin there. Well, it worked, and of course his colors were shown when President Trump lobbed in the 59 Tomahawk missiles, 23 of those which hit their target inside of Syria, there in home Syria. But of course, President Erdogan was sounding the cheerleading squad off there in Turkey, letting President Trump know that he did a great job, but he should have done more. Well, President Trump is planning on more. Remember, Ms. Haley, for the United States ambassador to the United Nations, also stated that the United States is prepared to do even more. Of course, she did back down just a little bit, saying they hope they do not have to. And of course, Boris Johnson, the foreign ministry for England, also speaking about standing with President Trump. He has canceled his meeting with President Putin inside of Russia at the Kremlin there. And of course, Rex Tillerson has not canceled his own meeting, but Putin is not saying that he will actually meet with him. He is supposed to meet with Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov will be discussing the situation inside of Syria. But I'm sure that President Putin is a little bit disturbed about the actions and, of course, the indirect threat that was made by Secretary of State Rex Tillerson to Russia, saying that they should rethink or reconsider their relationship with President Bashar al-Assad. They've really demonized him. We've covered this extensively on Israeli News Live about President Bashar al-Assad, that he's been demonized. We have had so many third-party groups going in, peace activists that have gone into Syria that have interviewed both sides, including President Bashar al-Assad, including the Free Syrian Army and even other fighting factions inside the nation, only to come back and say that it is clearly nothing but a Western propaganda to demonize President Bashar al-Assad for the overthrow of the country. Can't help but remember, and I've said it over and over and over, General Wesley Clark, and how he had gotten the intel and was brave enough to tell the world about it, that the United States was planning on taking down seven nations in 5 years. They didn't do it in 5 years, but they definitely are on course to take down all seven nations, with Iran being the last one on the list. But it looks like North Korea is kind of being thrown in the mix as well. Let's back up just for a moment, though. I want to take you to Ray McGovern and what he had to say in an interview here. A very interesting interview. I think it'll be a blessing to you about Syria and his own intelligence information that he has from military friends on the ground in Syria, and whether or not President Bashar al-Assad was guilty of gassing his own people. Listen to this.
Okay, Ray, what have you heard about this latest attack that caused Donald Trump to launch missiles? Have you heard anything from operations people who are on the ground there?
We have. Now, I must tell you that we have about 15 active members of VIPS. Some of them are incredibly well plugged into NSA, for example, and in this case, to the military on the scene. So we got word a day and a half ago that the attack on that, well, the attack that released these chemicals in Syria, this was not a chemical bombing or chemical missile or something like that from a Syrian aircraft. Rather, it was a targeted bombing or missile attack on what was suspected to be an arms depot in the rebel-held territories. Now, you want to get the arms depot, right? Little did the Syrians know, it was full of phosphates, full of all kinds of chemicals.
Right? And you've heard that from people on the ground?
That's correct.
Okay,
and people in the military. Now, the question is, of course, even though people at the, let's say, lieutenant captain level know that, and let's say they have the courage to report that up the line, there's no guarantee that other people who fancy themselves as mad dogs, as does the Secretary of Defense, Mad Dog Mattis, report that up to Washington. We have a guy at CENTCOM who has this kind of bloodlust for Syrians, okay? So whether that got up to the president or not, I can't say. All I can say is that everyone that I'm connected with used all the contacts that they had to make sure that the White House knew. And we are, through other channels, assured that indeed the White House did know, that the CIA played it straight, and yet Trump was persuaded by whomever to do what he did last night. And that makes it just a real, real, well, what's the word, a kind of a flashback into really bad times in the past.
That was very troubling indeed to hear that type of information, that the information, this intelligence that, according to Ray McGovern, that he had gotten from military sources that are aware of the actions on the ground, that the chemical weapons were there inside a rebel-held arms depot, a cache of weapons that they had there. As he stated, the Syrians did not know. And he said the CIA actually played their part in getting that intel back to the White House. But whoever it was that persuaded the president to make the attack regardless with this intel, if this really is factual information, and it does seem to be so, clearly we have seen the evidence of a buildup of troops and making ready for an invasion of Syria, all the way back to President Barack Hussein Obama, who authorized the Desert Camo military equipment to be sent to Germany, Germany to Poland, Poland to Romania, and of course Romania, they were only waiting to be loaded onto the ships sent down into Lebanon and also into Jordan, the Gulf of Aqaba, as we quoted you directly from Already Happened, the news source there, online news source with investigative journalist Lorenzo. And that information, along with the fact yesterday we reported how that the U.S. generals were meeting with the Lebanese officials to be able to bring in military equipment as aid, as they called it, for the military government because of the Syrian conflict. And of course, the U.S. and U.K. militaries, along with the Jordanian military, already crossing over into the Syrian border on the southern side, southeastern side of Syria, closer to the Iraqi border there, knowing that within 50 miles, they have the Iranian army there. Now they're claiming they're going in there after ISIS. We believe that it is nothing but preparing for the takeover of Damascus, where President Bashar al-Assad is still holding the stronghold there, and that these forces, the United States leading the way, are planning on taking this all down. Now, not only do we have a Rex McGovern, we have so many other voices that are out there, the White Helmets, etc. I actually have a video, and I don't think I have it available right now. I'll look and see if I can do it real quick about this. So you remember we shared with you the White Helmets and what they were doing as far as they were decontaminating these supposed sarin gas victims. But what was very interesting was in the process of their decontamination, they didn't use any type of protective gear when only one drop of sarin gas could easily kill a grown man. So that was all suspect to begin with. Now, Partisan Girl, she'd actually uploaded a video. It was very interesting, and I don't think that they allowed it to stay up. We'll just see if they did. It's this one right here. This was interesting here. This was a kidnapped journalist, John Cantell. And now John, he is captured by ISIS. He is being used to make propaganda videos. But when you go about halfway into this video, what's interesting is that a little bit better than halfway, watch, I'll have to blow it up on your screen for you here. Gosh, let me see. I don't want to lose this video here either. Let me just keep blowing up the screen so it'll get large enough for you to be able to see this. The White Helmets you're going to see in the background, all around him, in fact. And what's concerning to me is that these White Helmets appear to be part of the propaganda video. Okay, so let's just watch right here as he's being pretty much forced to do this video. You can already see the White Helmets in the background. There's one right here. All right, now just keep watching here for a moment. And by the way, Twitter will not allow this video to be retweeted. Back in here, you can also, they're going to kind of come into focus in a moment there. But there are more White Helmets here, all here. Now, there they are there. There's some more right here. All these are White Helmets here, and they're operating with ISIS. And if you really begin to watch the video, you'll see that these guys here are watching him very carefully, very carefully. So again, it is very obvious that ISIS is working. Look how close they watch this guy, you know, almost as if he is their prisoner. They're staying very close on top of him. And yet this is supposed to be the Syrian White Helmets to do all the rescuing of all the people that are being bombed. It is told now. See, well, here was interesting. Now they supposedly the Assad government is attacked and they're there for rescuing, but they're not doing anything. But they are working with that Partisan Girl. I want to just really congratulate her. She does a tremendous amount of work for uncovering all the evils that go on there inside of Syria. Also, Vanessa Bealey, another investigative journalist that spent much time on the ground inside of Syria, has also been there and is weighing in, saying that President Bashar al-Assad did not chemically gas his people. Very good information that she's sharing on this. Moving right along, though, let's go into some other issues here. The U.S. is completely unwilling to cooperate on Syria and consider other interests, is what the Kremlin is stating here on RT. It's really becoming a very tense situation in Syria, all right? Now, as we get on moving on along here, this is something I wanted to bring you back to. Remember how Russia Beyond the Headlines is the name of the article here, but there has been an alleged Chinese missile deployment near Russia targets the U.S., according to experts. That's what they were actually saying about the Chinese moving the Dongfeng 41 nuclear-capable ballistic missiles near the China-Russia border. Now, Russia was stating that this was no threat to their sovereignty whatsoever, and they weren't worried about it. But I have a different suspect on this whole issue now about the Dongfeng 41 nuclear-capable missile that was moved up there to the northeast part of China there, and what its real purpose and intent is. And this is what's going to really blow your minds out of the water. Remember when President Trump struck Syria with Russia standing there and Russian warplanes at the very same base? They say that Russia was warned by a third party means there, and Russia began to move its own planes out before the actual missile attack struck. But the fact that Russia was still there in the vicinity, and there was a risk at loss of life for the Russians as well. But while this was going on, while that strike was given the command to go ahead, President Xi of China was with President Donald Trump. Now, some say that it was a message sent to China. But do you remember what Rex Tillerson said? He said China understands that North Korea poses a threat and they seem to be more on board with us. I think that China has been on board with the President of the United States on taking down North Korea for quite some time. Now, again, I can't say that Kim Jong-un hasn't put himself in that predicament already, but what I'm trying to bring out to you, there's a lot of stuff goes on in the background that we never know about, and I'm thinking that now China is really not the great friend of Russia that Russia thought they were, just like President Erdogan is also not the great friend of Russia that Russia thought they were as well. I bring this out because on this article right here on mint.tc.net, it's a Japanese article, and this has already came out in the English language as well, by the way, but I just didn't have a chance to report it before it started popping up everywhere there. But at any rate there, 150,000 troops, Chinese troops, have been mobilized, and they were gathered at the Yalu River area in China. All right, now the Yalu River, just to kind of give you an idea where that's at, that's the Yalu River is right here. Where you see that dot at, that's where the Chinese government, well, actually the Chinese government is more up here in the middle section of North Korea there. But the Chinese government also has a base, actually they have a base up in this area here, but I don't know if this is where the troops are gathering or not because it's closer to Pyongyang, but China has moved a massive amount of force there, and also those nuclear warheads were moved up into that region there. I originally thought this was going to be aimed at the United States because it just gives them a little bit closer range air to target the United States from there. But now it's looking like just the opposite. The United States is building up its own military presence here with Seoul and South Korea. Japan also getting ready to launch that invasion from the east here, coming in on North Korea. The U.S. will work with them. The U.S. also sending in the strike carrier force there as well to strike North Korea. China working with the United States to take down North Korea. Guys, we have to really back up and relook at Daniel 11, the prophecy there, in light of what's happening. And I'm going to share that with you. Remember, though, like I said, President Xi Jinping was right here, waves to the press as he walks with U.S. President Donald Trump at the Mar-a-Lago estate in West Palm Beach, Florida on April the 7th, 2017, when the order was given to take out those warplanes, Assad's warplanes inside of Syria. Well, what's going on then? What kind of relationship has President Xi got with President Trump? Looks like Russia's relationship with China may not be as strong as we thought. Now, I'm only saying this is a conjecture. Can't rule it out completely that China won't end up siding with Russia later and end up turning on the United States. That's still a very good possibility. But we got to take some other things into consideration. Also, Tillerson, even China sees what a threat North Korea is to our interest. So it looks like that China was thinking this months ago. We reported it. We reported that DEFCON 41 was being moved into position by China, but we thought this was all over the United States. I noted, though, it was close to North Korea, but I didn't think North Korea had anything to do with it, because why? North Korea and China are actually allies. But that looks like all of that is changing. Let's jump over here to Daniel chapter 11, though, and take a look at some of the prophecies here, and maybe we can get an idea of what's going on from a biblical standpoint. Verse 38, but in his place shall he honor the God of strongholds, and a God whom his fathers knew not shall he honor with gold and silver and with precious stones and costly things. And he shall deal with the strong fortress with the help of a foreign God. By the way, that happens to be the British Empire working with the Vatican. Whom shall he acknowledge shall increase glory, and he shall cause them to rule over many and shall divide the land for a price. That land, by the way, was the Middle East after World War I. Remember, the British Empire, with a very close covenant with Rome, began to take over this land after they toppled the Ottoman Empire, and they divided that land up. And Israel really faced a backlash from Great Britain in this process as well, as Great Britain made a promise to give all this land and in 1920 for a Jewish homeland, including everything west of the Jordan River and east of the Jordan River, including the modern-day country of Jordan. But it didn't take but 2 years before they changed their mind. And as the Bible says, for a price, they divide up the land. And yes, they give Abdullah II, King Hussein's son, the land of Jordan as a prize for helping them to defeat the Ottoman Empire. So that land has been being divided up for a price. And then, of course, didn't go much longer than that. In 1947, Resolution 181 was dividing up the land again. Yet it was supposed to be a Jewish homeland. I guess that was just all a pretext. It really wasn't a Jewish homeland. It was a Rothschild invention, no doubt, in order to take over all the Middle East. But you have to understand, what they were not expecting was that the Jewish people would actually get to that homeland and begin to build a nation. They did still have their puppets inside the government that they made sure got in power there and continue to get in power, such as Shimon Peres and others as well, that have been able to manipulate the government there of Israel into doing a lot of dirty work for Rome, including that of working against President Bashar al-Assad there in Syria. But the land has continued to be divided up. Remember, during the Holocaust, no Jews were allowed to migrate to the land that was promised to them. Instead, they tried to let Hitler kill off as many of the religious Jews as they possibly could, and secular Jews as well. But after the war, they finally made it home. They began to build their nation. That's why I am for a Zionism where the Jews that are coming home to see their Messiah, to recognize who their Messiah is. I am for that, but I am not for a Zionist political Zionism of the Rothschilds. Totally against that. Of the greater Israeli project, I am completely against this type of ideology altogether. But biblically, we can see what goes on. And they said they would divide the land for gain. Remember, the British mandate was for Israel. The French mandate was the Syrian Empire. And all these empires were redivided up, the lines redrawn, all by the British Empire to begin with and the allies that helped them to conquer this land. Now, we move on, and of course, I guess we see that Bashar al-Assad is not being the good boy that they expect him to be, so therefore they're overthrowing him and taking him out of power. You know, it's kind of interesting. They say that he gassed his own people, but you know what's interesting? In 2012, Bashar al-Assad outlawed GMO food being allowed to come into his country because he cared about the health of his people and did not want their DNA affected by GMO food. That's interesting, isn't it? Man does everything that's totally against a New World Order. Maybe this is why they really want him out of power. Moving down to verse 40, in a time of the end shall the king of the south push at him, and the king of the north shall come against him like a whirlwind, with chariots, with horsemen, with many ships, and he shall enter in the countries and overflow as he passes through. Now, some people try to say that this is Russia, but it's clearly definitely not Russia. Russia only came down to one country, Syria. But the United States, who happens to be the military arm for NATO, for the Vatican itself, who runs the United Nations and NATO as well, they have actually overthrown all of these countries. As it was said by General Wesley Clark, that the United States was going to topple seven Middle Eastern countries. Remember that? Including Libya, Lebanon, Syria, Iraq, Iran, all these countries. We didn't forget about that, I hope. So what did we find here? He enters with his horsemen, and he shall enter into the countries. That's a very interesting word right there. When it says, and he shall enter into the countries. All right? Barasot. Uva or uba barasot. He will enter into the countries. This is not Israel that he's entering into. It's the surrounding neighboring countries of Israel. It is Syria, Jordan, Iraq, Iran. It is all those countries there that he enters into, including Jordan as well. To do what? He enters into there. He overflows them and passes through. He shall enter also in the beauteous land, and many countries shall be overthrown, but these shall be delivered out of his hand. Edom, Moab, and the chief children of Ammon. Well, Moab and Ammon right there happen to be the Jordanians, and of course you're dealing with the Palestinians. Wow, didn't know that one, did you? He shall stretch forth his hand also upon the countries, and the land of Egypt shall not escape. That sounds familiar, doesn't it? U.S. billions prop up military that toppled Egypt's president. Well, what do you know? All right, so He's not going to let Egypt escape, but he shall have power over the treasuries of gold and silver and over precious things of Egypt, and the Libyans and Ethiopians shall be at his steps. Well, that's not only the U.S. topples Egypt, but also U.S. warplanes launch bombing campaign on the Islamic State in Libya, also toppling Libya. And as you might remember, we did an article ourselves back on December 16th of 2015, Pope Francis, Does He Really Care About the Poor? And in this article here on IsraeliNewsLive.org, we go into the aspects that with the U.S. government's help there and banks, they are toppling Ethiopia in order to be able to steal all the mineral rights that are there, using force, heavy-handed tactics to kill the local residents that don't comply with getting out of Dodge. Very interesting, isn't it, how this prophecy in Daniel goes? But it's going to get more interesting because we're going to be looking at another part of this as well. But tidings out of the east and out of the north shall affrighten him. Well, it doesn't really, the word in Hebrew there is not really a fright, you might say. But they trouble him. They aggravate him. They irritate him. And because they irritate him, he shall go forth with great fury to destroy and utterly to take away many. Now, I still think that that king of the north, it's not the president of the United States. It is the Roman hierarchy. But they're dictating to their general, their chief general, the president of the United States and Great Britain, as to what to do about this. And they're going to destroy and utterly make away many. But it's trouble, it's tidings, literally, in Hebrew, you're looking at this right here, umetzifon, that is from the north. All right, the tidings are from the north. So Russia entering into Syria becomes something that irritated them. And it irritated them heavily. They did not anticipate Russia coming in. Something that John Kerry said in one of those interviews there that he did with Syrians, the part of the Syrian resistance against Bashar al-Assad that was secretly recorded and released publicly. He said that was an unexpected thing that Russia entered into Syria. They intervened, and that's what irritated him. So he has to take them out of the way. But also the tidings out of the east, they're another problem for him. But notice what he's going to do. He's going to go forth with great fury to destroy and utterly to make away many, to slaughter many. That'll happen in Syria, and I believe that North Korea may be the other region that this is speaking about. Because China seems to be working with the United States. And because of the nuclear weapons that are there, I think this is why China has gotten involved in this battle with Pyongyang. Again, it was all secretly done. Pyongyang probably never suspected that those nuclear warheads that were being moved over there on the north side of his border, that many experts were writing already about, that this was for the United States. I even thought the same thing. It was for the United States. All along, months and months in preparation, they've been preparing to take down North Korea from the very beginning. 150,000 Chinese soldiers ready for the battle. Thousands, tens of thousands of South Korean soldiers, United States soldiers, air power, etc. They're going to make away many. And we'll see Daniel's prophecy unfold. And he shall plant the tents of his palace between the seas and the beauteous holy mountain, and he shall come to his end, and none shall help him. I think that's where it begins to speak about the Pope of Rome. But it's interesting, though, when it speaks about the tents. Could that even be the moving of the U.S. Embassy to Jerusalem? Could it be the Third Temple? I've always kind of held to the Third Temple, but the mere fact that it says tents of his palace between the seas and the beauteous holy mountain, not really sure how that plays out there. I have to pray about it and see how that turns out. Anyway, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. Thank you for helping be a part of the work that we're doing here, and we thank you for your support and your continued support. I'm Stephen Benoon with Israeli News Live, Erev Tov.